Google knows everything. What you search, what websites you visit, your age, phone number, your location. It also holds so much of our stuff, from emails to photos and files. So what if your Google account gets compromised? How are you supposed to protect all of that? Actually, you don't have to look far for an answer. Google itself has a security system called Google Security Checkup. If you're using Chrome on your PC, you can easily reach it through the account icon in the corner. Just click Manage your Google account and find the Security tab. Here, click Protect your account. If you're on your phone, you can reach it through Settings, or why not take a weird route and open your Google Security account straight from YouTube through your profile tab. Yeah, whatever floats your boat, you know? Whatever device you're using, this is approximately what you should see. Well, it varies a bit depending on what Google thinks is most urgent, but you get the idea. Let's start from the basics. If you haven't yet, add your recovery email in the sign-in and recovery section. This is super important in terms of how to secure a Gmail account, as a recovery email will help you quickly and painlessly get back your main account if it ever gets hacked. Also, check your sign-in verification methods here, as this extra login step can help prevent threat actors from breaking into your account. You can add new methods of 2FA through the two-step verification settings. You don't need to set up all of them, just choose a couple that are the most convenient to you. Google will also suggest to turn on the safe browsing mode. If you haven't done it yet, this can prevent you from accessing potentially malicious sites or downloading questionable files, so yeah, it's a very useful thing to have. Right, next up is your saved passwords. If you don't use the Google Password Manager, you might not see this, but if you do, I highly, highly recommend you use the Password Checkup, at least once in a while. This strong password checker will reveal compromised, reused, weak, or old passwords and give you an option to change them, which you should do immediately, especially if they're compromised. Changing reused passwords is also super important, since if one account gets hacked, it opens the way for a credential stuffing attack. This is when threat actors use leaked login details to access other accounts. That's how 500,000 Zoom accounts appeared on the dark web for sale, and there are many, many more cases like this. So make sure your passwords are different and strong. If you want a strong password example, it should be at least 8 symbols, a mix and match of symbols, numbers, and letters. And if you want to protect them, I suggest replacing the Google Password Manager with something a little bit more reliable. I use NordPass since it's cheap, it's convenient, and has additional tools like the Data Breach Scanner, which notifies me if any personal data leaks occur. There are other options as well, but personally, NordPass is my current favorite, so I highly recommend checking it out. Now, if we go back to the account protection page, you can also check what devices are currently logged into your account. If you see an old device you don't use anymore, sign it out. And if you see any suspicious accounts in here, sign them out too. And then go change your password. By the way, in case you're using a VPN, you might see the same device but a few different locations. It's totally fine, you're not being hacked. Then check recent security activity. Look for anything sus, and if you find that, click the See Unfamiliar Activity button, and yes, you guessed it, go change your password. Finally, your third-party connections tab will show you apps which have access to your account. Simply remove the ones you don't recognize or use to make sure that your account is as safe as it can be. Overall, I recommend going through the Google Security Checkup at least once in a while. It's really quick to do anyway. And don't forget to use additional security reinforcements, from proper passwords to 2FA. If you found this video useful, please leave a like and consider subscribing. I'm on my way to 5K. Thanks so much, and I'll see you in the next video.